this moment even better, because do you ever have a moment where every decision in your life suddenly makes sense? When you've walked through a really dark time and you suddenly become aware that you were the light that got you to where you are. Has anyone ever had that experience? I'm having that experience right now. So, my name is Tara. Nice to meet you. I've been in this industry 9 years, and January 1st of this year, I was about to retire. As a professional dancer for 20 years, I knew when the time came that I needed to retire. And I looked at the same thing from this profession. I looked at everything. I lost belief, I lost motivation, I lost momentum, and I was thinking, well, I have a lot of skill, I can build a lot of, I can do something else. And that's really where things took a turn and brought us to this moment. I also have really bad ADHD, so all those little things, it's like, oh, squirrel, what's happening? Anyway. You guys, this is my skin. I heard all that, yeah. I heard it all. My birthday is this week. I turned 44 on Thursday. When I turned 43, it was like, happy birthday! Here's horrible skin. I'm not joking, I never had bad skin in my life. I'm a board certified health and wellness coach. I've worked in health and wellness my entire life. I did every gut health protocol, every yeast cleanse, every heavy metal detox, everything I could possibly do from the inside out. Topically, I tried everything, nothing would work. When Chris and Tim came to me with the Riman opportunity, I said, I cannot do skincare. Now, I said that because I'd worked in health and wellness this entire time, but what they didn't know is I couldn't do skincare because that's what my skin looked like. How do I walk around selling skincare when that's what my face looked like? You guys, that's with makeup, okay? Well, all right. I have without makeup, too. I'll do this in a second because the slides got a little messed up, but when they, January 1st came, Chris said, Tara, please, please, just try it. Just try it. Do me a favor and just try it. And I said, fine. He's like, all 8 steps. And I was like, oh, dear God. You guys, I was lucky to wash my face. Like, 8 steps. Like, what is happening? All right, fine, Chris, I'll do it. 4 days later, I called him and I said, we need to talk. My skin had cleared up. You guys, 7 days later, this is actually my skin. Still with makeup on, you guys, I had a lot of redness, okay? A lot of redness. But the bumps were gone. It was deep bumps, too. They were really painful, you guys. Now, this is my skin without makeup. It's actually the same skin, but what you can't see, you see the redness, and it was always like this. You can't see the texture. And so that's why, oh, there it is. That's why I use the makeup one. Which is also why I'm telling you, when you share before and afters, you guys, it's okay to show who you really are in real life and say, hey, this is makeup because look at the texture, okay? And we don't always have to do it the way everybody else does it. You can tell your story the real way. And after 17, this is about 3 weeks on the products using the full X line, this is what happened. I was about to retire from this industry 3 months ago. I am now about to be 44 this week. Tomorrow is my 3-month anniversary here at Riman, and I need everybody to do me a favor and help me celebrate our rebirth, if you are willing. Will you guys help me? I am claiming that 44 is my rebirth, and so if you guys can turn the lights on your phone, please, on. Everybody stand up, please. Turn those lights on. Y'all got lights on your phone. Everyone knows how to turn those iPhone lights on, right? Can we help me celebrate, you guys?
It's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip a party like it's your birthday.
That's how you help me celebrate? Come on! Look at my face! It doesn't look bad anymore!
need to feel a buzz. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug. You're into getting rough. You can find me in the club. Bottle full of bub, mama, I got what you need.
You guys are amazing. Okay, go ahead, go ahead, go ahead. Sit down. Thank you. All right, so put this down and watch. I forget it off stage too when I go. So I have the pleasure of talking to you guys about culture and systems. And here's the reason when I was asked to train on this that it meant so much to me. When I made the decision I wasn't going to retire, I had been, anybody in here ever been in an unsafe situation before? Nobody raised their hand? Okay, some people are talking. Anyone ever been in an unsafe situation in business before? Do you know the fastest way to lose money in business is to go into business with something you feel unsafe in? I knew if I made the decision to come here and build this, I had to create a culture where everyone felt safe. In fact, there's a joke, they call our team the Trauma Warriors, just so you know, because everybody has come from an experience that might not be their most ideal situation, but that's life, right? The older we get, the more things happen to us, right? Yeah? And the older we get, the more lessons we learn, the wiser we become, the stronger we become. And yet a lot of us carry that on our back like there's something wrong with us. Oh my gosh, they're going to know this happened to me. They're going to know this. You guys, nobody knows when they meet you for the very first time. They meet you. They look at your eyes. Guess what? The fastest way to connect to someone's heart isn't through their eyes. It's not in their head. Your heart doesn't beat in your head. So most of you need to get out of your head. But I knew if I was going to be responsible for a lot of people, because I'm like super impatient, like, yeah, my birthday's this week, I'm an Aries, I'm impatient, I have a lot of fire, I knew I had to go fast. In order to go fast, I needed systems in place that could support that. I also don't like to be a babysitter. I'm actually a really bad babysitter. So I wanted to empower other leaders to have the same thing in place. And so I knew that that was important, but something stood out to me. Experience the difference you'll love. When Riman first came presented to me, that stood out to me really strong. Can you guys all think of things you love? Think of it for a second. I bet one of those things is probably a person, right? That often becomes our why. It becomes our motivator. It becomes the things we protect. And I was thinking a bit about this last night as when Danny was up here yesterday sharing about when he met his wife and the timing of that. But see, he had to say yes. These opportunities come and he had to say yes. But because Chairman An said yes, Danny could say yes. Tim and Chris were able to say yes. I was able to say yes. And today, in only 3 months' time in our organization, 750 people have had the opportunity to say yes. I don't even know what's happening. And in the future, I know that number was going to be the hundreds of thousands are able to say yes. But see, every time you say yes, that means you have to say no to something. You guys want to know something I will never say no to? I will never, ever, ever say no to my favorite team. This is Team Truax. This is why I do everything. Leadership is neither a rank nor a title. It is a choice. The choice to provide care and protection for those for whom we are responsible. Simon Sinek, your team, you're responsible for them. But your family, you're more responsible for them. And that culture, that value, what you provide to your own personal family, if we take that structure, we take that foundation, and everything we say yes to only supports that. You guys, these are our main shareholders. If we continue to invest in our main shareholders, this will continue to thrive, and your team will continue to thrive. Because you will have a happy environment. You guys, when you go home, there is someone at home. If you have children, you guys, there is someone at home. There's someone at home taking care of your kids. There's someone at home supporting you so that you could be here. Don't just text them thank you. Go home and look them in the eyes and tell them thank you. You guys, my husband is always sitting right in the front row every time I speak. He could not be here because right now he's driving my son, Sutter, to practice because he's in dress rehearsal. because he is starring as Mike TV in Wonka the Musical. It is his dream to be in theater, and his dream to be in theater because of what he's seen me do. Because I said yes to something, it inspired him to do something. So he's on FaceTime. Hi, babe. Because he won't miss it. He shows up for me 100% of the time because I show up for him. My oldest, Sage. Sage, Julian's story was so powerful to me. Julian actually shared with me last night that he was diagnosed on the autism spectrum. Sage is also diagnosed on the autism spectrum. He has become my why for everything. I had to get out of the dance studio. I was a dancer. I worked in the studio. I was a professional dancer for 20 years, but this industry brought me out of the studio to be home with him because I had very small children at home. And because of that, showing up for my family in the best possible way, we were able to make multiple seven figures in this industry. But again, I had to take a hard thing and say yes. And I was not going to say no to them. He inspires me to do more and be more and show up. But you guys, like Julian, I look at Julian and I'm like, man, that's my son. That is so motivating to me because you would never actually even know. He's brilliant. And then you got my little fireball, Presley. Presley comes to events like this, you guys, and she goes, where's the people? I got to go talk to the people. She's a professional network marketer, like professional. No joke. Friday, I get a phone call from Mike, my husband, Mike. He goes, we have a problem. I'm so mad. Like, what happened? He goes, she was at her friend's house and they left and they went door to door trick or treating. You guys realize it's April, right? They went door to door trick or treating. She's six. He finally found her. He couldn't find her in the neighborhood. He finally found her. So mad, she's grounded. She's like, what? I was fine. I was with Eleanor. I'm fine. Oh my God, there's no convincing her. She's never wrong. She's always right. And she will convince you to do anything. You guys, I will never say no to them. So they have to be, everything I build has to be important to them. So when you build a structure and foundation for your team, it has to be stable. The stability has to be there. I knew that too as a dancer, you guys. I would train dancers from very, very young to become whatever they were going to become, but you had to build a foundation. And foundation takes skill. Foundation takes time. Foundation takes patience. Remember what I said? I'm really impatient. I'm so impatient. But it takes time and doing the same thing over and over and over to become good at something. But the most important thing, you guys, when you build any system and structure, everything I'm going to talk to you about today, if it's not relevant to you, if it's not current to you, if it's not purposeful to you, put it in your back pocket for now. Because later it might be current or relevant or purposeful. But if it's not now, don't do busy work. Busy work doesn't pay the bills. Every single thing you invest to a yes, remember, you're also saying to a no. So it has to be an investment to your future. And this is what I put in place literally the day I decided we were doing this. Because systems take the stress off the structure of the team. And I wanted to know that the leaders that I brought into this business could trust me, feel safe, stable, and build their own strong teams. And you guys, that's literally what we've done. Now, some of the tools we use, you guys, now we've seen a lot of people build belly to belly. We've seen, and I do believe in working with people. I'll talk about that in a second. But I have built 99% of my business in this industry online, okay? 99% of my business I've built online. 100% of my business stabilized, structured, and stayed sticky from showing up in person, okay? I built it online, though. Now, when I do that, I have a very, very widespread team. I have people all over the place, and a lot of times I don't meet them until I'm at an event because they're everywhere. And this is global, by the way, too, because this is how I built. But these are tools. These, all three of these right here, you guys, all three. And these are actual screenshots of my team boards, my team Canva, my team Milkshake. All three of these apps, you guys, are free. You can utilize these in any way you desire. I will tell you, these are also paid options as well. We do pay for them. I do pay for them because I like tax write-offs, but you know, you can decide what you want. But you can add more benefits if you do choose to pay for them, but this is absolutely free. So for boards, this was the very first thing I thought was the most important thing I did because I could put all the information. I went to the drive, which you guys, Riman has, having that drive there is so phenomenal. I went to the drive. I pulled those resources. I put them in one place because the cool thing about boards is on your keyboard, there's a little globe. You can connect it there and I can send this video. I can send this PDF. I can send whatever straight from my keyboard. It is amazing. And then any video, any recording, anything, I can just put it in folders and I have it all separated. So my team can go there wherever they are, whoever they are, and access all that information very, very simply. Remember what I said, it has to be purposeful, resourceful, and it has to take help them grow without taking time from me. We created a Canva landing page. That landing page, you guys, we sent for customers. And this is actually connected to a testimony group that they want to have more benefits. So it's not, you don't enroll with one person in it, in a simple landing page. We also have, use our Milkshake. So Milkshake is like a, it's like a website, but we put all our onboarding links there. That way it's easy to people get in the chats, get in the team page, get in the, you know, you can see all the things listed there in one spot. So I don't have to send 900, oh, did you join this site? Like, we have different, we have people with different comfort levels at different places where they want to be more accessible or less accessible. So we put it all in one spot. Now I built boards, but my team built the other pieces for me, okay? Because they had great skill. If you have someone in your organization who's really good at something, they're like, let me do this. Please do. Let them take it over. Let them, we let our team have success in the things they're great at because I can't. I can't do it all and I can't be it all. Now we use tools for communication. This is some of you guys when you try to communicate. You get all wrapped up and you don't know what to say. You do this in recruiting. You do this, well, what do I say to my customers? What do I say? You do it, you think you you don't know what to say to someone when you recruit them. You think you're suddenly gonna know what to say when they're on your team? Like, probably not. Like, we need to simplify it, you guys. Our team, okay? And I know a lot of you guys like WhatsApp. I'll tell you, we had to shift off Facebook Messenger completely to Telegram. And I'll tell you why, and this is really good for business. Telegram is phenomenal for business, and I'm not marketing anything. It's free too, by the way. But the Telegram app lets you drop topics. So we have a whole convention topic running where everyone can put one thing in there. We have a before and during. You can take your whole chat and separate it by topics to keep it easy for your teams to also search. Remember, I'm trying to simplify, not just for me, but for my leaders. For smaller groups, we always use Messenger. Zoom calls are really important to bridge for launching, for getting my people face to face. Now we use the calendar Danny has in place. We have the orientation every Tuesday. We have the Thursday op call. Our team specifically goes between in and does opportunity calls. And you guys, what's really cool about that is I'm going to bump over to the in-person events. We use those opportunity calls as recognition. So we use for the testimonies, you guys, that's recognition for somebody that's shining, for somebody that's working hard. I will use them for the testimonies, for presenting, who's doing the front half, who's doing the back half. Tim and I talk about it, like, hey, who's, and I'm like, this person. And that is how we go in between. So we always have something to tap people into. We utilize the Facebook groups. We have our own as well for just like testimonies and stuff. It's important that you stay compliant with that, you guys. But within, we use the Riman Planner Connect Facebook group. And we also do a lot with social media posts. Now, depending on whether you guys have your own brand, some of you guys do, we have our own team as well, or you want to use the graphics within what Riman has too, it is really important to recognize the hard work our team does. And the way we need to do that is by actually saying it. Because think about it, as a mom, I go through all the things I do for my family over and like so much, right? And do I really get recognized? No, I get told I put the milk in the wrong cup, I used the wrong plate. Like, it's always wrong, right? So let's give some recognition for our team who is showing up for us just in the same way we're showing up for them. Now, this is the most important sticky stuff. Remember when I said about to the eyes, to the heart? During the pandemic, I learned this was the most important thing. Culture is the lifeblood of a vibrant society, expressed in the many ways we tell our stories, celebrate, remember the past, entertain ourselves, and imagine the future. There's this real important line there. It says lifeblood. Lifeblood. If you do not have blood, you die. If you do not have blood pumping through your veins, you die. This is so important, you guys, that we connect and create sticky. During the pandemic, when we could not be in big groups, I learned getting very small groups together in what we called retreats each month, okay? And I lived in New Jersey. We had to quarantine for 2 weeks no matter what, okay? So I would go, I would do something, I'd fly home, I'd quarantine, I'd go and I'd do it again. And we weren't breaking any rules, okay? Don't go like, we weren't breaking any rules. We were going by the amount of people that were allowed, small groups. We would bring them together. And I realized in that time, we created stickiness. I got to know people's families. I got to know their dreams. I got to know what happened. You guys, some of the big, actually my team leaders that are here now, came to me from being at retreats where I had a really connected conversation with Jackie. I had a really connected conversation with Katie. You guys, these conversations happened one-on-one and at retreats. When Kel came to join, you guys, we're gonna do a launch event. We're gonna do a launch event and we're gonna bring these people in. Nobody knows me. Kel's organization, nobody knew me. And we all went to Florida. And I met all of them for the first time. And these people became family just in a short weekend. I'm not saying go get a really big house it is really fun to get a really big house on the beach. It is really fun. But you can do it small. You can do this in very small groups. You can do it in a small Airbnb. It could be just at a hotel one weekend, but do something special within your groups to create connection. This will continue to keep your team going, and it can be something you do as recognition and reward. You can use it within your team to earn it. And this is very, very something I am so passionate about, you guys, because we live in a world of filters and fakes. These products make it so you don't have to be fake or live in a filter, right? You don't have to be. Every single one of you came here with some sort of hope in your heart, something that you wanted to go back out there and overflow to others. And all of us are just human beings living life, laughing and creating memories together. All of us, we are Riman, each one of us. We support each other no matter what system, what culture, whatever you create. Remember, the value of what you bring is the most important thing. You are the person that said yes. You're the person that said yes to be here. You're the person that said yes to overflow to others. You're the yes. You are the yes. Do you all understand? You are the yes. So the next time you say, I can't, you need to say, no, I am the yes. I am the yes. Because if I can come up here and have my own Riman rebirth, you guys, at age 44, I can have my own Riman rebirth and decide this is where I'm planting my feet. This is where we are. This is where we're growing. We are really all in, you guys. Are you really all in? I'm sorry, what? I don't believe you. Are you really all in? Thank you. I'm Tara Truax.